After 2 months of pretty much silence, Dan TDM has finally come out to speak on the topic with KSI. And honestly, he has such a positive outlook on it that it just makes the whole thing comedic. Now, for those of you that need a little bit of a recap, you know, maybe I need to take you through a time machine because you've already forgotten about it. I know how the internet is nowadays. Shit like this just blows over like it's nothing. When Lunch League first got released 2 months ago, Dan TDM came out and spoke about it, basically just saying how he was sick of YouTubers making trashy products. And KSI went fucking bananas over this. He couldn't contain his anger. He even went as far as to dig up a 9-year-old video of Dan TDM promoting a candy box thing to try and one up Dan TDM. And it didn't just end there. He dragged it out all the way up until his song Thick of It got released, which is an absolute banger, by the way. 73 million streams. Oh my gosh. What an amazing song. Really, KSI, well done, mate. But throughout that entire time, he was just getting constant hate, and it wasn't even from Dan TDM fans. It was from the entire internet. Anyway, fast forward 2 months. Dan TDM just hopped on a podcast with Tommy in it and Jack Manifold. So yeah, let's get into it.
The whole Twitter stuff that happened, the aura was quite strong.
That's what he goes on about. I think
I couldn't believe that. It was like,
was it mad?
Yeah, like the whole, it felt a bit Game of Thronesy. Like the whole internet like had my back, which was kind of wild.
Oh yeah, it was really cool. Was it? Were you just sat in your room like, this is a bit mad?
I'm honestly so proud to say that I was a part of that. Like, I watched all of it unfold. I have a video on it with like 200k views. It was absolutely bananas. Like, it genuinely did feel like Game of Thrones. I felt like I was in Endgame with the Avengers, you know. And then you had KSI, who was Thanos, with, instead of a fuck off big chin, a fuck off big forehead. And Twitter was just exploding. You opened up the app and it was something new about the whole situation, and everybody was talking about it. And for those of you that, you know, were maybe born like last month, I know you're definitely watching this video right now. I'm sorry that you missed it. You know, I really am, because that was a fantastic moment on the internet.
It was like awesome. And then the living the dream.
Living the dream was crazy. He's been crying for like 2 weeks straight, and you come in and just like, I have a great life. That was incredible.
That was my way of like...
The funniest part about that tweet is KSI tried to replicate it, but KSI's life genuinely looked worse. Like, Dan TDM's life now, he's living the family life whilst just making videos and just doing things that he enjoys, and it just looks beautiful. Like, even when I saw that, I actually felt inspired to go and get married, you know, have horses at my wedding or some shit like that, have children and just settle down, even though I'm not even 20 yet. But that tweet alone, like, it just looked fantastic. And that response was a perfect bit of gasoline to fuel KSI's fire.
He didn't know that you had more aura than him.
I don't think I did either, but...
Yeah, you definitely do, bro. Oh, that's sick, man. It was awesome watching. Seeing all that meme of like, no one speaks ill of this man, and it was like, oh.
I'm about to say something extremely controversial. It might even blow some minds. This whole situation with Dan TDM is bigger than the Ninja Low Taper meme. I know. I said it. I'm sorry. But it's true. It's actually factual. I mean, the entire internet came together here, and it really did show the aura of Dan TDM. I know the saying aura is kind of cringe, but it's a good way of defining it. Like, Dan TDM isn't really that prominent in the internet nowadays, but all he had to do was just comment on a singular topic, which people weren't really too fanly of, to instantly prove how powerful he is. Like, it really doesn't matter how long this guy disappears for now. He can come back at any point and people will still be fans of him. It is absolutely bonkers.
I don't think he's never not been the top dog before. The way I described it is like, if you're in school and like me and Jack are year eights and he's like a year 10. And then for the first time ever, the really kind year 11 goes, no. And he's like, never had that happen before.
I think that was the perfect evaluation of it. I wouldn't even say year 11. I'd say year 13. That's the kind of aura that Dan TDM had. Like, he doesn't really care that much anymore. Like, he's not invested in that kind of social scene. But when he takes a step into the arena, wow, it is pure destruction. Like, KSI really was throwing his little tantrum, wondering why on earth he wasn't so powerful. He was like, what on earth is going on here? Like, why are people hating on me? I mean, he even made videos talking about, why do people hate me for this? And it's like, brother, what is wrong with your head? Like, he's got to be a fucking lobotomy patient or something like that to think that he could actually test Dan TDM and have it go his way.
I couldn't be bothered to like fight. Like, he loves the whole back and forth. That's what the whole boxing stuff is
about. That's
what he wants,
like,
isn't it? I understand it, but it was funnier to not feed into it because
it's just exhausting.
You just watch it happen. It was fun.
Was it fun? It was just fun to sit back.
It was funny.
Dan TDM played his cards so unbelievably well. It's almost as if they're in a chess game and Dan TDM somehow found a way to make a checkmate in one move. And KSI was like, what on earth is going on? This is so unexpected. And Dan TDM was like, yeah, man, that's just how the ball rolls when you come into my world. Because although Dan TDM made the initiating tweet, KSI was the one who stepped into his arena. And all Dan TDM had to do was just let KSI just kind of spin around with a sword in that arena. Just, you know, maybe slowly cutting himself up to actually show that KSI was in the wrong here.
He's still kind of going. He's still, I think I was in his YouTube title a week ago.
He's still on it?
Yeah.
Come on, man.
Because I can't make a song as good as it, could I?
I could
never get 50 million streams. That was the whole thing.
Don't get me wrong, I understand people will still talk about this situation. I'm literally doing it right now, but this is like the end of it, I suppose. The fact that KSI is still milking it as like a primary situation is just lame. Like, over the past few months, this drama has been non-stop, and we've seen all three titans of YouTube, KSI, Logan Paul, and MrBeast, having their own controversies, and it's finally coming to an end. I'd say Logan Paul's one was long gone, you know, that was finished a while ago. MrBeast is definitely coming to an end, and this is like the final evaluation of it, and it's just the cutting point for KSI, where KSI kind of has to just give it up now. Like, this kind of stuff isn't going to get views forever, and people aren't always going to be interested in it, and it's nice to know that we kind of have a finale to it.
I think some of it as well was interesting, where I think he thought like it was all my fans going for him, when actually I don't think that was the case.
No, it was the internet.
It was like, I think,
you know what we were saying earlier about when you have an impact beyond today and yesterday?
Yeah, yeah.
It wasn't like you could make a message like, guys, stop. Like, these people aren't the people actively watching the videos,
yeah,
particularly. Like, these are the people that just like have fond memories.
Yeah, it really was quite an interesting case of the entire internet coming together. A rare occasion, I know, but everybody knew to back Dan TDM. I really don't care about getting accused of being a glazer for this guy, because I will happily glaze Dan TDM. There's no shame in it whatsoever. This guy's an all-time legend, and he was always going to win this battle against KSI. But the thing is, I wouldn't even go as far as to call it a battle. It was more of just KSI's kind of wet fart of an attempt at trying to beat the top dog against someone who is always going to win.
But my wife was always like, just think before you tweet. That was one time I didn't really think too much before tweeting. Usually I'll type it out and be like, no, I can't bother, delete it.
Yeah.
So then I didn't tell her for like 3 days, and she's not on Twitter really. So I didn't tell her. And then I kept getting notifications from my phone. I was like, oh, Logan Paul's responded. Jimmy's messaged you. KSI's responded. I'm going to have to mention something now.
That is the exact kind of partner that you need in this situation. Like, she is very aware of how famous Dan TDM is, and it's important to kind of get perspectives from other sides of things. Like, the life that Dan TDM lives now, he doesn't need any more money. He doesn't need any more fame. He has everything that he needs. He is quite literally set for life, and everything that he does now is just for fun and for the sake of his children, and that's all he needs. He really doesn't need anything else. So I don't really call this a scenario where he's come out of his shell to kind of come back for one last battle. It's just him putting his opinion out there and then accidentally showing who the fucking king is. So yeah, man, absolutely fantastic response from Dan TDM. It really is what we wanted to see, and I'd say this is the perfect finale to it all. This is the true ending. This is exactly what we wanted to see. Thankfully, no one got hurt from this. There's no real harsh feelings behind it. I'm sure Dan TDM and KSI could sit in the same room together and have a good chat. But yeah, man, I'm happy to see this come to an end, and that's about it. See y'all.